Friends, in the previous video, I had explained the working of turbines and we had just started one problem on Pelton wheel. We will work out some more problems on turbines, hydraulic turbines. Now I am taking a problem from April-May 2017 paper. April-May 2017. Question number 16. It says two jets strike the blades buckets of a Pelton wheel which is having shaft power as P is equal to 15,450 kilowatts. This is the power output of the turbine. The diameter of each jet is D is 200 millimeter. If the net head on the turbine, it is wrongly printed here as 400 mm, it should have been 400 meters. Find the overall efficiency of the turbine. Take CV is equal to 1.0. That's it. Number of jets, there are two jets. Okay. Find the overall efficiency. As we know, the formula for efficiency is P divided by WQH. So if you have to find efficiency, we should know everything here. Now P is given, P we know, W is 9.81, that is constant, that will be okay. H is given. Now what is not given here is the Q. Without Q, I cannot get efficiency. So first we have to find Q. To find Q, Q will be equal to number of jets into area of each jet into velocity of jet. This gives me the discharge. Q is discharge. So this is N. This is area will be pi d square by 4 into velocity of the jet is capital V. So I know N. N is 2. I know D, dia of the jet, but I don't know V. So first I must get V. V, that is velocity of jet, will be CV into root of 2GH. So first I must get this V. CV is 1 into root of 2 into 9.81 into H is 400 meters. So this will be 2 into 9.81 into 400 equals this much. Square root of answer will give me 88.6 meters per second. 88.6 meters per second. This is V. Now I got V. We will substitute that V there in this formula. N is 2 into pi into D square. D is 0.2 square divided by 4 into 88.6. that will give me the discharge in cubic meters per second. So this will be 88.6 into 0.2 square into pi into 2 divided by 4 will be, Q will be 5.56 cubic meters per second. This is the discharge. Now that discharge, if I substitute here, I get the efficiency. So efficiency will be equal to P 15,450 divided by 9.81 into 5.56 into H is 400. So 15,450 divided by 9.81 divided by 5.56 divided by 400 gives me 0.708. That means it is 70.8% into 100. If you multiply it by 100, it gets converted into percentage, 70.8%. So that is the efficiency of the turbine. This problem carries 10 marks. 10 marks, first you have to find the velocity of jet, then discharge, then substitute that discharge here, you get the efficiency. We'll do some more problems, some more numericals. Now I am taking numericals from the question bank. I am taking question number 22 in the question bank. Question number 22 in the question bank, it goes like this. A Pelton wheel is required to generate 3750 kilowatt. So this is the power to be generated under an effective head of 400 meters. 400 meters is the head available, net head. Find the total flow in liters per second and the size of the jet. Total flow means Q. Discharge is how much? He wants it in liters per second. And the size of the jet means the dia of the jet. Assume generator efficiency. Generator efficiency is 95%. 0.95. The overall efficiency is 80%, that is 0.8. Coefficient of velocity CV is 0.97. Speed ratio is 0.46. If the jet ratio is 10, jet ratio is 10, find the mean diameter of the runner wheel, mean diameter of the runner, capital D. So this is the problem. Now you see here, we have a turbine. This turbine is coupled to a generator. This is the generator. The power to be generated here, the output of the generator is 3750 kilowatt, right? So what is the power to be delivered here? Now power of the turbine must be equal to power of the generator divided by efficiency of the generator. The input which is given to the generator is the power of the turbine. What the power given by the turbine, that it gets converted into electrical power, and electrical power required is 3750 kilowatt. So 3750 divided by efficiency of the generator is 95%, that is 0.95. So 3750 divided by 0.95 gives me 3947.4 kilowatt. Now turbine has to supply this much power so that the generator gives that power. So this is the power of the turbine. For our purposes, this is the power. Now next, we have to find out first discharge. We know overall efficiency of the turbine is P divided by, this is power of the turbine divided by WQH. We are not going to use this power. This power is used only for calculating the power to be delivered by the turbine. Now this power, from this equation I have to get Q. You know everything except Q. So Q will be equal to P divided by overall efficiency into W into H. So this power we will use, 3947.4 divided by efficiency, is now overall efficiency is 80%, so 0.8 into W is constant 9.81 into H is 400 meters. So substitute them, you will get Q. 3947 divided by 0.8 divided by 9.81 divided by 400 gives me 1.257 something, 1.257 something cubic meters per second. He wants it in liters per second. So discharge of the turbine, that is the quantity of water to be supplied to the turbine, Q is equal to 1.257 into 1000, that is 1 cubic meter is 1000 liters. That means it is 1257 liters per second. Liters per second. He wants it in liters per second, so we will give it in liters per second. But for further calculation, we use this because we want it in cubic meters per second. Then this is done. Next, after discharge, we have to find out the dia of the jet. To find the dia of the jet, I have to use the formula. Q, discharge is equal to area of jet, that is A, into velocity of the jet, A into V, or it is pi d square by 4 into V. Now I have to get D from here. To get D, first I must know V. Now V is velocity of jet, the velocity with which the jet enters the turbine. This is capital V. This is CV into root of 2GH. So CV is 0.97 into root of 2 into 9.81 into H. H is 400 meters. So 2 into 9.81 into 400 is equal to this much, square root of that, square root of answer multiplied by 0.97. will give me 85.9. You can take it as 86 meters per second. 86 meters per second. That is velocity of jet. Now, we know Q, we know V. So, I can get D. D is equal to square root of 4 into Q divided by pi into V. So, this will be root of 4 into 1.257 divided by pi into V is 86 meters per second. Next, 4 into 1.257 divided by pi divided by 86 equals 0.0 under root, root of answer 0.136 meters. Say you can take it as 0.14 meter. We can take it as 0.14 meter. Okay, we got this also, die of the jet also. Next, he wants this capital D. Capital D, that is the die of the wheel, mean die of the wheel. To find out that, what I do is, he says, D by D is 10. Jet ratio means capital D by small d. This is given as 10. So capital D, that is die of the runner, will be 10 times small d. So 10 into 0.14, that will be 1.4 meter. 1.4 meter. Now, this speed ratio we have not used, that can be used like this. Speed ratio means small v by capital V. Speed ratio is speed of the, or velocity of, speed ratio means velocity of wheel divided by velocity of jet is called as speed ratio. So, this is given as 0.46 is equal to V by V, or small v, that is velocity of wheel, small v, velocity, small v will be equal to 0.46 into capital V. We will get small v like that, but it is not necessary here because we don't require it. You can know it, that's all. Usually they will give that velocity speed ratio will be that much. Okay.